Hello, my dear audience. This should be the last in the series. Late at night, well, it's not really late, it's only 5:30 on a Tuesday night, I'm going to talk to you about the concept of identity from a sociological perspective. Identity is a complex and multifaceted aspect of who we are as individuals, and it's shaped by various factors such as our culture, society, experiences, and self-perception. So, how do we know our identity? Well, identity is something that develops over time and can start to form from a very young age. As we grow and interact with the world around us, we begin to form a sense of self, which includes our beliefs, values, attitudes, and behaviors. This sense of self is influenced by the people we are surrounded by, the messages we receive from society, and the experiences we have. For example, a child may start to develop a sense of gender identity as early as age 2 or 3, as they begin to understand and express their sense of being male or female. This sense of gender identity can continue to evolve throughout their life and may or may not align with the societal norms or expectations. Similarly, other aspects of identity, such as race, ethnicity, religion, sexual orientation, and socioeconomic status also play a role in shaping who we are. Our identity is not fixed, but rather is fluid and can change over time as we learn more about ourselves and the world around us. It is important to note that our identity is not solely determined by our internal perception of ourselves, but is also shaped by external factors such as societal norms, expectations, and institutions. Society plays a significant role in influencing how we perceive ourselves and how others perceive us. For example, societal norms and expectations around gender roles, racial or ethnic identities, and social class can impact how we view ourselves and how others view us. However, it's important to recognize that our identity is not solely defined by external factors, but is also a deeply personal and subjective experience. It's about how we see ourselves and how we want to express ourselves authentically in the world. In conclusion, our identity is a complex and multifaceted aspect of who we are, shaped by various factors such as culture, society, experiences, and self-perception. It's something that develops over time and can start to form from a very young age. Our identity is not fixed, but rather it is fluid and can evolve throughout our lives. Sorry about my dog. It's important to respect and affirm the diverse identities of individuals, recognizing that our identity is deeply personal and subjective. So let's strive for a society that promotes inclusivity, acceptance, and understanding of diverse identities. So thank you for your attention. So in other words, identity, I identify as an artist. I identify as a mother. I identify as Caucasian. This is not gender. That is part of identity. I identify as a female, Caucasian, poor, economic, well-educated, intelligent woman. So there is a mixture there of what makes me. There, externally, biologically, I am a woman. I identify my gender somewhere along the line as a woman. I am attracted to people, to personalities. I identify as a singer, as an author, as a mother, as a grandmother, as a daughter, as a sister, and I identify as Jem Amberstone, age 62. I can identify as Leonardo da Vinci, for example, but I don't. But that identifying as a painter is being a painter. That's not identifying as a gender. Identifying as a painter is not identifying as either male, female, non-binary, or nothing, neither female or male or both. So gender is just part of identity. Identity is shaped by external and internal forces and is the complete package of who I am. But who I see myself today is not who I saw myself as 60 years ago, or 20 years ago, or even yesterday. So gender is only part identity. But gender and biology are not the same, just as biology and identity are not the same. Biology influences identity, but it is not the same. All right, this video has come to an end. I think I am done with this series. I can't explore it anymore. And I do want to let you know that I have post-grad qualifications. And the first qualification I got was a Bachelor of Arts, of which I did a double major in sociology. So I do know something about sociology. I've also studied psychology, and I've also published a book called The Social World, Our Creation. And that's what it is, a creation. Who we are, we create. It's a creation. Okay, I'm done. Thank you for watching. Whoever you associate as, you are important, for every life matters and every life is equal. And let's be kind and just to everyone. Thank you for watching again. Cherish every moment. Love the best you can. I love you. And now we've come to the end. And I hope I don't have to do any more videos on biology or transgender or gender or identities, because I think I've exhausted it. I'm exhausted. Good night. Bye.